The Sahih has four categories, you can say. The first one is the top one, Sahih, Bukhari and Muslim. So anything which is not Sahih, Bukhari, Muslim, it is never can be treated as the first one. It's impossible. Then second category is those hadith which are Sahih, but they are not in Sahih, Bukhari, Muslim. They are either in other books of Bukhari, Muslim, or they are in Abu Dawud, or Tirmidhi, or Ahmad al-Hanbal, and other people say. That's second category. Third category of the Sahih are those hadith which are declared Sahih by people like Hakim, Ibn Hibban, Ibn Khuzaimah. They are not so strict. And the fourth category, I don't want to make it Sahih, but because there's so much problem in this world in these days, and people are making, everybody making the Sahih, and so much confusion. And actually sometimes they say, so and so narrator, we don't know any information about that. Though the person will be in one of the known book. I remember once the book was published from Ummul Qura University in Saudi Arabia. It's a small book of the Hadith. On the first page, there is name of the narrator, which I actually mentioned, Abu al-Abbas Ahmad ibn Abi Talib al-Hajjar, who is the best narrator, or the highest narrator of Sahih Bukhari. His name also came in the Sanad. The person who did editing of the work, from Jami' Ummul Qura, he wrote a footnote and said, Lam a'athur ala tarjamatihi. I did not find his biography. Ask anybody, his biographies are everywhere. Well-known person, he is the main narrator of Sahih Bukhari in the world. So this actually what happening is, so many people have seen over time, they keep doing this thing. Sometimes they are confused between two names. One was a weak person and one is reliable. They don't know that they are two different people. They make out the same category. So that why the fourth one actually is not a category. The third one is by the experts, still expert, Hakim and Khuzaimah, they are big people. So they are little loose, but they still know what they do. They are consistent. The meaning is, whatever they do, they are consistent. In our time, people have no consistency. Same person, you can see, a same hadith, in one of the book he will write, Sahih. Then same hadith in other book will say, Daif. Do you know what the problem is? The problem is, when he was writing this book, then he consulted this source. So he thought Sahih. In other book, he consulted other sources. He does not know that he already has discussed this hadith somewhere else. They don't have this in mind. So many contradictions really. Not one, 500 contradictions. Just imagine really. How can you trust? People in our time, there are people who have contradictions. How many contradictions? 500 contradictions in their works. It becomes impossible for anybody to follow those people. So that's why, even the third category is much, much better than all these people. So that keeps in mind. Now is coming to what actually is the condition of Bukhari. Imam Bukhari never mentions anywhere what are his conditions. So he does not do this. Muslim also does not mention properly what his conditions are. He discusses in Muqaddimah something, but not properly his condition. Abu Dawud does not do. Tirmidhi does not do. Nasai, nobody does really. You have to discover from their books. The way they have written, you have to discover that. I have consulted all the books which are written on this thing. I don't want to read all them, but I will summarize the whole this argument to you. Simple thing is, for Bukhari Muslim to include any hadith in their book, at least you need five conditions. First one is ittisal. Second one is adala. The third one is dabt. The fourth one is adamu shudud. And the fifth one is adamu al-illa. And I'll explain to you all these five properly, so you know when a hadith comes in Sahih Bukhari, what actually happening is. Ittisal means the Bukhari will only include a hadith in his book when a student narrates from his teacher, and teacher narrates from his teacher, and teacher that he narrates from his teacher. Yani everybody must be taking from their teacher. For example, if I narrate a hadith and I miss out my teacher, I narrate from the teacher of my teacher, I miss one link. Then it is not ittisal. Ittisal means connected. Every link must be mentioned properly. Is it clear? Everybody must be taking the hadith from their teacher directly. So like for example, a simple example of the first hadith of Bukhari. Like Bukhari mentions the first hadith number one bin Niyad from Humaydi, from Sufyan, from Yahya ibn Sa'd al-Ansari, from Muhammad ibn Ibrahim al-Taymi, from Alqama, from Umar al-Khattab. Meaning is, Bukhari has got the hadith from Humaydi. Humaydi got from Sufyan ibn Uyayna. Sufyan got from Yahya ibn Sa'd al-Ansari. and Yahya got from Muhammad Ibrahim al-Taymi, and Taymi got from Alqama, and Alqama from Umar, and Umar got from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So then hadith is muttasil, the connected. If any link is missing, hadith never can be in Sahih Bukhari or Muslim. It's clear? But this is not what they look. Then they go far more than that. That what you do. Because when I narrate from my teacher would have got many, many students. My teachers, all students are not equal. Some are very clever, some accompanied him for a long, long time, and some only for a short period. You know, among all my students of my teacher, who are the most reliable? Those who accompanied with him long time, because they have must have the same hadith from him many, many times. Those who are very clever, bright mind, thinking properly. Bukhari goes for that. Is it not enough that you pass by Medina and you attended one class of Zuhri and now you are proud that I learned from Zuhri? This does not impress Bukhari. You must spend with Zuhri 10 years, 8 years, 9 years. And you must be among the bright students of Zuhri, not those who just, you know, come in the class and sleeping. Bukhari does not take hadith from those people. And that's why they, in the past they used to write this thing. You know, like in the Sama'at, you know, when I did my research on Muhaddithat, female scholars, one thing that helped me is that this tradition has been that after the class, they used to write at the end of the book of hadith all the names of the people who attended the class. So there used to be somebody appointed there, and he used to sit and notice everybody's single body, men, women, children, old, everybody's name. And not only that, they will also write who attended the class from the beginning until the end, who missed these hadiths. They will write down, so and so was from this hadith to this, and then he missed this. And actually, they also, you know, like by Haqiz Sunan, you know, in the Sama there, it also written that so and so in the classroom was sleeping. It is also written. Now, if you go and narrate that hadith, everybody knows that you are sleeping in the classroom. In the book, it is written now. They wrote at the end that so many people in the class and so he came by sleeping. And also they write, this woman was there with her child and the child started crying. So she looked him, took him outside to make him quiet, and she missed these hadiths. That's also there. You never can do dishonesty. So much, you know, things are. So it is not enough that you say I studied with Zuhri. That's not enough. Bukhari will ask you how many times do you spend with Zuhri.